Oh yeah!
Hello everybody, it's me, I'm Friendly Porcupine. Today I'm very excited about this Hot Wheels Mega Constructs Monster Trucks Roger Dodger and Hot Wheels Racing set. Yes, one of the figures is named Hot Wheels Racing. Go figure! I hope you caught that pun. Anyways, this set contains 251 pieces and retails for $24.99. This is kind of a little bit bizarre since everywhere else I've seen it, like on Amazon and on Target, which is where I got this set from, it was $14.99, the retailing price. I don't know why, but it was. Okay. On the official Mega Construct set, it says $24.99, so I assume that's the official retail price. Other than that, let the review begin. Now, let's talk about the box, since the box is actually used as part of this set. It's a very special box, so of course it's thick. You'll see it has these little markings right here on the side. Very specifically designed, so that way you can actually build a little set out of it. So you can see right here, there are like little lines across it. You can see this right here? There's already some opening up right there. You can just do that easily. Right there. Yeah, that's exactly what it's designed for. Okay, so you get two little instruction booklets. Nice. Then you get all of these, and look at that. They have numbers 1, 2, 4, and 3. Isn't that amazing? A set that actually comes with actual numbers. Wow. The instruction booklet is according to the numbers. What a revolutionary concept. Now that's awesome! And my, these books are just such nice quality, like wow, look at that! Oh, and that exactly shows you what I was talking about. So how exactly do you make the books a platform for cars to roll on? Well, this is how. You see this little part right there? That part pokes out and sticks right into here. So what you essentially do is you see this part right here? That part. You fold it in and just pop it right on in. Where'd you go? Yeah. And there it is. That keeps it in place. Do the same thing for the next one. Pop that in. Slide it in. There we go. Boom. There you go. I really like this replayability value. And then you just slide those things kind of in. See? You just... There you go. Now you can actually take your Hot Wheels vehicle and do this with it. It adds definitely something. Then you have the little one. Yeah, so clearly not intended for the little one. The bigger one, absolutely, it can handle it. But like, come on. They incorporated some playability features from the box. This is something that you would just throw away. But now it has an actual point to exist. Yeah, definitely not bad. Now for the feature presentation, the cars. Introducing Roger Dodger. Hello, Roger Dodger, how do you do? I think Mega Constructs has accomplished exactly what they wanted to do. They essentially made this vehicle look like a very nice Hot Wheels car, which it very much does look like, and it's brick compatible. This is one of the things I see Mega Constructs and Hot Wheels collabing is a very good thing. And it couldn't have happened with Mattel, so that's one good reason Mattel has collabed with Mega Constructs. As for this vehicle, first things first, the durability on this thing is insane. I love it, like, mwah! This is super good durability. Playability is going to get points on through the roof. Let me show you exactly just how durable this set is. Okay, so here's the thing. I threw it like that. Didn't break whatsoever. No break. Look at that. Look how insanely rough I am, like a crazy madman. Nothing is happening. It's still good as new. Can you do that with an official Mega Constructs Call of Duty set? Probably not. Damn.
That is insanely good. Of course, no ordinary kid is gonna be playing it like that, like I am, but that just shows you the point of stability. It's in fucking sane.
Anyways, let's talk about the aesthetics of the vehicle, which I really, really like. I like this design that they input. You see that? They use that little piece right there, that little piece, and it gives it a nice groove. They'll perfectly fit with this piece right here. And then on the back, they also incorporate that piece. The prints are done very nicely. I like this right here, you can see. You can see right here, these are bricks, and this is a print. And it flows just so very nicely. I like it. I really, really do. And then the black part of this brick fits perfectly with the black outline of the fire. Wow, and it's done very nicely. However, the only bummer is it doesn't have any doors. I mean, if you want a door, you can just do that, so... that doesn't really count. Since I ripped off his door like Terminator, let's actually see who's inside. Oh, wow! You probably are shocked by the scale of these figures. Here's just a comparison of the Call of Duty figure. Yeah, of course we'll go into more detail with the figure, but that's kinda crazy. Wow. It's almost like a little child. And just in case you're wondering, this is what happens if you try to fit a Call of Duty figure in there. It's just not going to work. Just remember that even if it doesn't fit with a Call of Duty figure, you can always use all of these pieces to make something that actually does fit with a Call of Duty figure. Anyways, as for the wheels, they spin very nicely. Like, wow, very nice. Look at that. I like it. Very excellent. Plus, the way they use this piece right here, you see that? One yellow, one black. This piece right here that they use, it perfectly allows the wheels to spin without any problem of friction. Moving on to the front, you can see it's a very nice silver color. I like the aesthetics of this. Though the only thing I think is kind of missing, maybe there could have been a light over here, just like how there is a very, very nice light on the back. Yeah, this design is super simple, but it's super good. Yeah, I just only wish there were more lights on the front or something like that. One thing I really do like is the way they did this engine. Wow. Now that's good. Also, there is a super new interesting piece that I've never ever seen before. Yeah, that thing that I just pulled off is an actual piece. Yeah, that's gonna increase customization a lot. You can attach this anywhere you wish. Like, let's... Okay, that don't work for those. Let's attach it to this. Boom, there you go, now you have this. So if you want like a little ring around any stud, there you go. That's what it's specifically used for. And it looks excellent. It also kind of reminds me of Squidward, if you think about it. A little bit too much. Also, this little spike right here doesn't get in the way too much. So it's not gonna like fall off or break. So that's actually structurally very stable. All right, where did the figure go? And just to show you, with these figures, you see, they also have studs right here. That's also why they don't move side to side. A very lame reason, I wish they still did. But anyway, put them in here. This is how it works. You don't have to even attach them to the studs, though it is better that you do. Remember, he doesn't have to be in the studs as long as he's in there. Because most of the time, if you're playing this for playability, you're not gonna wanna waste time putting in the figure. You just want them to be in there and done, which you can easily do. You pull off hood, take your figure, slide them in, attach, and you're done. That's it. Now you're ready to play go crazy like Twisted Metal, vroom, or Hot Wheels. Also, one last thing I forgot to talk about was these little mirrors right here. Yeah, they don't have a mirror paint on them. Well, I don't think it's really needed, but it would have been a nice touch. But what's nice, of course, with them is you can adjust them. Anyway, speaking of Twisted Metal, say hello to Hot Wheels Racing! Yeah, you can clearly have a lot of fun with this. So, with this awesome monster truck that they have designed, look at how nicely this goes. So, you lift it up slightly and you can just ride it over. Boom, and flip it over. Flip it back, boom. Vroom, 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 vroom. Yes, clearly you can have a lot of fun with this. However, if you just push it, you're just gonna do that, which we don't want. What you want is to lift it up just a little bit so the wheel can roll. Then you do it just right. Anyways, enough about this vehicle. Let's talk about the Hot Wheels Racing. Yes, that's actually what they named this car and this character. Now imagine fighting Hot Wheels Racing as a Twisted Metal character.
Hammerhead raced across the rooftops of New York. Inside, Mike and Stu, the drivers of the truck, were salivating.
That would be a bit weird.
Anyways, I'm very delighted to know that once you actually open it up, how are the wheels? Well, at first I thought they were just going to be a light blue. I was shocked when they were actually silver. With these awesome Mega Constructs Monster Truck silver tires, you can now add these on to all of your other Call of Duty custom vehicles, which is really dope. Anyways, as for the rubber material, you get a nice squeeze in there. Just listen there, just listen. Yeah, of course this is if you really, really squeeze hard. They squeeze very nicely. And they also can give you a little bit of a bounce. So that's good. And look at this feature right here that they incorporate. So if you remember the Halo ATV set, right? The Halo Infinite one. This is a very, very similar concept, just with bigger wheels. So if you want to, you can get it stuck like that and all you have to do is push and that's it. If you wanted, you could also switch it the other way around and all you have to do is push and it rolls. I really, really like that feature. It makes playing with it a lot more fun. So yeah, this set's gonna get a high playability score. As for the actual structure, well, that's how it looks like. To me, it might be a little tall, especially considering the figure skill, but then again, this is a monster truck and it's supposed to be big and tall and savage. It's supposed to scream at these little tiny figures, get out of the way! Otherwise, that happens. Anyways, moving on, let's actually see this pickup truck, because without these wheels, it's just an ordinary pickup truck. So yeah, you get the Hot Wheels logo right there. Moving on to the side, you also get the Hot Wheels logo right there. This is Hot Wheels Racing. You get another portion of Hot Wheels over there, then you get the actual Hot Wheels logo over there, so yeah, you clearly get a lot of Hot Wheels prints on this vehicle. Moving on to the back, they just put in two little lights right there. Nice, they're designed like this. So it's just a one starter, which is nice. Moving on to the front, they actually have some lights at the front. Something this vehicle could have actually used. Anyways, moving on to the back, that's how they did this little pickup part. You can actually rotate these if you want to. Move them up and down. Of course, you just leave them down because it creates that aesthetic. Then, once you're done playing, they also have this very nice piece that they use. See, it makes a very nice aesthetic. Anyways, this is what you do. You just take this part off and there you go. Now you can swap it out with any other figure. So, hasta luego figure. Well, actually here he is. Hot Wheels Racing. We'll save you for the figure review department of this video. Anyways, that's what the bottom of this looks like. We'll just push that in a little bit. Yeah, it looks pretty good. It does the trick. And that's what the interior of it looks like. You get a nice blue wheel over there. That is slightly speckled and of course a blue tinted window. Now just to compare each vehicle's interiors. Oh, and of course let's have our honorary moment of care package pieces. Care package pieces, care package pieces, care package piece, care package piece, care package piece, care package piece. Yeah, clearly there's a good edition of care package pieces. Yay! I always like it when they include those pieces, because then I can swap it out any color with my care packages, Call of Duty style. Now, if you've seen on the front of the box or from the previous video, let's
swap the tires!
Yes, exactly what that guy just said. And this is what happens when you swap the tires. I like it. I genuinely do. This is an excellent playability feature. Yeah, Hot Wheels Racing, you think Roger Dodger's done with you? Boom! Yes, it's actually pretty tough. However, there is one little tiny problem with this one. Well, you see, if you look very closely over here, this wheel right here, when you take it off, it perfectly has these studs to attach it to. This one, on the other hand, it's actually just attached to one. So yeah, how do you do that? You just attach it to one. Meaning this problem can easily happen. You push here too hard, boom, your piece kinda came off. Ay, ay, ay. They could have easily simply just provided us a one more three starter to fit in right there, and problem would be solved. Which you can easily do yourself if you have a spare. Now just for some fun, we're gonna swap the tires again, but this time give the little ones to the big truck. And when you switch them out, you get a tractor, which kind of looks stupid. I mean, it actually works, like it actually drives, so it does the job, but it kind of looks stupid. But in a good way, stupid. Think farmersonly.com. This is exactly what they flex. City folk just don't get it. This is how you pick up them country girls. Well, this is what happens when you swap them out. It looks like a lowrider gone bad or a super inaccurate London bus. Now that right there ain't gonna pick up no country gals. Now if you have wheels like this on your car, all the country gals are gonna go crazy for you. Now let's talk about the figures. I might as well just show them both at the same time. Let's do a nice rotation. One thing I really like about these figures are, of course, the excellent prints that they have done. Mega Constructs knows how to do their prints. Another thing you might have actually noticed is the head mold is actually the same head mold used in the TMNT Foot Soldier. Yeah, so if you want those TMNT Foot Soldier head molds in different colors, well, here you go. And what I really like is the head mold actually moves very nicely. This is still way much more better articulation than Lego. As for the articulation, you can move the figure side to side, rotate it fully up and down. You can do all of that. You can also rotate the hands, which is nice. Same with both the other hands. However, the feet is where they start to suck. You can see, they move just like Lego feet. They move up and down and that's basically, oh, they can't even go fully back. So yeah, Lego's a little bit better in that department. But at least they also have the advantages of Lego, which is you can attach them to studs. So, yay! But I also wish they could also move side to side. But then again, this is on a smaller scale, so yeah. If they move side to side, you would have to keep constantly aligning them so that way they could stick to studs. I believe that was the reason why they weren't able to move side to side. And of course, everyone to their own cup of tea, these type of figures are just not for me. Now, what would be for me is if these figures were Call of Duty system. Now there you go. Now that is what I call awesome. And of course, the best part is if you absolutely hate these little tiny figures, at least you get excellent head mold that you can use for other figures. Also, you can create what type of an abomination this is. Anyways, enough of that.
Did you say snap? Stab it with Slim Jim!
Alright, boys and girls, it is time for the final judgment! For the aesthetics, I give this set a 9 out of 10!
The vehicles aesthetically look very excellent, there were no boo-boos with the prints.
For the playability, I give these awesome trucks a 10 out of 10!
You can one, say it with me!
Swap the tires!
We just wanted the most optimistic thing that you can do. Number two, they are insanely terrible. I can throw them around everywhere and they're not going to break. Playability goes through the roof.
I would love to put these in the ring. Just imagine.
Okay. Let's not push it that far. Okay. I don't think these would actually survive a real monster truck. Oh, and I forgot. The figures, which you can easily pop in and pop out of the vehicle. There is none of this super crazy adjustment that
except
you have to
for
do.
Me, I'm friendly porcupine. I can't even get in. That's how big and macho I am.
Anyways.
For the value, I give it a 7 out of 10. It's standard. It doesn't meet my standards, but it's pretty good. What do you think, unfriendly porcupine?
Exactly what you said, and I was supposed to do the talking this time.
No. This is my show. You're just a guest. My truck's my show.
Do you want me to kick you off of my show? For the value, it's pretty standard. However, if you try to buy these sets separately, like a monster truck set, which is about $20, and the small car set, which is about $10, the add 20 with 10, you get $30, and this costs $25. As for right now, you can get this set for $15.
That's a sweet $15. And lastly, for the build, I give it a 9 out of 10.
The build I think is one of the best aspects. The only reason this set does not have a 10 out of 10 is simply because for this track, one of the pieces was not included for structure.
So when you swap the gym.
Yes, they need to hit the gym and let me finish.
Carry on.
Okay. What I was saying with all this stupid motherfucker trying to interrupt me. I understand.
You better watch your mouth, boy.
Okay. What I was trying to say was, here, you can see exactly what I was saying. They should have included a piece to fill this part in, so that way it would be more stable. Other than that, the build is one of the best. I can throw it around everywhere, does not smash. And no one in the right mind, except this little fella right here, only this guy would like to try to run it over with a semi-truck.
I'm gonna body slam you, monster truck.
Calm down. Let me finish the review before you smash everything.
Or before I drive a semi-truck right through your skull.
And for the final score, I give this set...
Can't read that, I'm friendly porcupine. And for the final score, I give this set a whopping 8.75 out of 10. Can you dig it, my brother?
Yes. How about you dig yourself out of here?
Thanks for having me on, Unfriendly Porcupine. I better get on out of here. I got better things to do than mess around with you.
First of all, I never even invited you. You just came along. Since you weren't causing too much of a problem, I decided to keep you around.
Oh, is that so? Snip into a Slim Jim, Unfriendly Porcupine.
Slim Jim doesn't pay me. Say something else.
Well, why don't you hit that like button and subscribe for more?
There you go, my friend.
And check me out in the ring. Cause I'll be whopping and dropping and monster truck bang ya.
Now there we go. That's why I didn't kick you off the show. Because of that, not your rudeness. You need to be more respectful next time.
Understood. Now. Here are two excellent videos you can click on. Watch this one. It's the one where I talk about monster trucks. Or how about this one, where my friendly Pokemon talks about my big arms and my big...
Yes. Gonna flick you off. You're welcome.